Hello dears, today we will learn about how to find out the perimeter of a square. Previous we learned how to find out the perimeter of a rectangle, isn't it? So the equation to find out the perimeter of a rectangle is 2 into L plus B. So here also we have an equation to find out the perimeter of a square. Okay, so we all know that a square looks like this, isn't it? This is the structure of a square. What is the peculiarity of a square? What is the features of a square? That also we learned, isn't it? All four sides of the square is equal. The four sides of a square is equal. Equal means what? Same. For example, if it is a square ABCD, okay? If AB measures 5 cm, then BC is also 5 cm, CD also 5 cm, and DA, that is also what? 5 cm. That's why it is called a square. The four sides of a square is equal. And in the case of a rectangle, opposite sides are equal. Okay, so this is the peculiarity of what? A square. This we already learned, isn't it? These things we already learned. So this year, we will study about how to find out the perimeter. I told you what is perimeter, isn't it? The area around it, isn't it? The length around it, isn't it? Total length around is this square, isn't it? So just imagine that if the one side of this square is indicated as, we don't know, we are not writing an exact value. Just imagine that if AB is S, okay, S can be any value, just saying, I'm saying, if AB that measures S, okay, and BC will be what? Same S, isn't it? That we learned, isn't it? This S means this also S, and this is also S, and this is also what? S. I'm writing or indicating or putting the length of AB as S, English alphabet. Letter, yes, small letter S, okay, not capital letter, small letter S, okay. So this ABS means all sides of this square is what? S. So how can we write this perimeter? What I told you, perimeter, to find out the perimeter, we need to add all this length, isn't it? So how can we write the perimeter here? Perimeter will be what? Perimeter, we can write a perimeter. Perimeter is equal to S plus S plus S plus S, isn't it? If I'm adding all these three, four S's, I will get the perimeter. So how many S I wrote? 1, 2, 3, 4. So 1S plus 2S plus 3S plus 4S, isn't it? So how many S is there? This is one, this is 1S, and this is another one, isn't it? 2, 3. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Total how many S's? 4 S's. So I will write as the perimeter of a square is 4s, 4 into s. Why I write this way? I will tell you. Suppose this s is 3 cm. Suppose this s is 3 cm. So I am writing or I am going to find out the perimeter. If side is, s means side, okay? If s is 3 cm, how can I find the perimeter of this square? Okay, so instead of s, we have to write a 3 in here, isn't it? Because s is 3 means, then perimeter I can write as 3 plus 3 plus 3 plus 3. What is 3 plus 3 plus 3 plus 3? 3 plus 3 is 6. 6 plus 3 9. 9 plus 3 12. Isn't it? That I can write as 4 times what? 3. 4 3. Isn't it? 4 3s are what? 12. Isn't it? 4 times 3. Actually, multiplication is repeated addition to, isn't it? That's why we wrote a few 4 into s. So to find out the perimeter of a square, we have to multiply the side into 4, or 4 into each side gives what? The perimeter of a square. 4 into each side gives the perimeter of a square. Okay, so that's way we can find out the perimeter. Okay, suppose, so this is the equation to find out the perimeter. Okay, perimeter is equal to 4 into side. For example, a square has side of 10 cm. Side of 10 cm. Then what is its perimeter? Perimeter is equal to 10 into 4 into 10. So 10 into 4 and 4 into 10. 4 into its side is equal to, you will get a 40 cm, isn't it? So this way we can find out the perimeter of what? A square. So this is where we are finding the perimeter. Now let me ask you a question. Okay, here it is given us a perimeter of a square is, suppose it is 16 cm. And what is the side? What is its side? Okay, so perimeter is given as 16 cm. to find out, so here it is perimeter, we got the answer, that is final answer, perimeter it is given, but it does not give us what, it does not give the side of this square. We need to find out this side. How can we find out? To find out the side, we have to divide perimeter by 4. Understand, what is perimeter? It is 16. 16 by 4, we will get a 4 centimeter. Okay, maybe you doubt it, how we are getting. Let I will show you how it is getting. Suppose a square has side 10 centimeter. Okay, what is its perimeter? 10 in 4 into 10, isn't it? That is what, 40 centimeter. So just imagine that we don't know this 10 centimeter. So the question is that the perimeter of what? Perimeter of a square is given as 40 centimeter. Okay, so we know that the side would must be what, 10 centimeter. So just imagine that we don't know this one. Okay, so how can we find out from this value? How can we find out this 10 from this value? We know that the perimeter is 4 into side, isn't it? 4 into side. Okay, to find out the side, I told you this one when I am beginning of the time, that means previous time. Okay, that time I told you about when we take the things on the other side, on the equation sides, we have some rearrangement is there. Okay, to find out this side, 4 into side is perimeter. To find out the side, we need to keep side on one side, yes, isn't it? And we need to take this 4 into the other side of the equation. Okay, to when we take the other side of the equation, here we can see that the 4 is multiplied. Okay, so here we need to divide. With, okay, when 4 comes to this side, 4 will be divided. Okay, for I am writing this, just imagine, okay, that may be confusing. Perimeter is equal to 4 into side. Instead of that, I am writing 4 into side is equal to perimeter. Same it is, isn't it? 2 plus 3 is equal to 5, isn't it? 2 plus 3 is equal to 5, then 3, 5 is equal to 2 plus 3, that way we can write, isn't it? Like that, the perimeter is equal to 4 into side, 4 into side, okay. Or 4 into side is equal to perimeter, this way I can write, isn't it? So both are correct, okay. Okay, to find out the side, we need to take this 4 to the other side of the equation that I told, okay. To find out the side, I am going to take a 4 to the other side. So, side only on one side. Side is equal to, how you can write it, perimeter is already on here, perimeter, okay. When side comes to this side, 4 is multiplied here. So I told you, when something we are taking to the next side of the equation, if it is multiplication, it's become division. If it is a division, it's become multiplication. If it is an addition, it's become subtraction. If subtraction become addition. That is the rule, okay, in maths, okay. So here 4 is multiplied. So when I took here, it's become division. So perimeter divided by 4, we'll get a side. Okay, this is the explanation. If you're not understanding this one, you just study to find out the side, we need to divide perimeter by 4. Okay, so if any question is given as perimeter, you just divide it with by 4, you will get the side. Okay, just divide. Perimeter is on the angle. Perimeter is 4 on the divide, you will get the side. Okay, so this is the way we are finding out the what, side of what, a square. So this is the equation. Okay, now next is what, a triangle. Perimeter of a triangle. That is quite easy. Okay, perimeter of a triangle. Because to find out the triangle, you just add the three sides only. There is no other derivations. Okay, just imagine this is a triangle ABC. To find out this, perimeter, suppose this is 3, this is 4, and this is 5. What you have to do? 3 plus 4 plus 5. Or AB plus BC plus CA. We can write this in it. What is the perimeter? The AB, length of AB plus length of BC plus length of CA. Okay, then what we will get? Length of AB is 3, length of BC is 4, and length of CA is 5. So 3 plus 4 is 7, 7 plus 5, 12 centimeters. So that is the way we are finding out the perimeter of a triangle. Okay, this is the last one. Okay, this is the perimeters we have to study. Perimeter of a rectangle, perimeter of a square, and last one, perimeter of a triangle. Okay, yes, that's all. Thank you.